Good afternoon, dear children. So in my yesterday's video, we have studied about the adverbs and the kinds of adverbs, that is adverbs of place, frequency, degree. So these all we have studied. Now let us see how do we place these adverbs in a sentence. What is the position of these adverbs in a sentence, right? So now here, first one, like when we have the adverbs of manner, time, place, at that time we will place this adverb after the verb or after the object if the sentence is having an object, right? So here that means, remember, adverbs of manner, time, place, we have to place it after the verb, that is action word, or after the object if the sentence is having an object, right? So now you see in this example, you can go now. In this sentence, I have got the subject. So the subject is you, but I do not have any object, right? So that means now which one I am going to take? The sub which is having after the verb, okay, which is not having any object. So in this sentence, I do not have an object. And where do I place then? You can go now. So that means can is my auxiliary verb, right, or the helping verb. Then go is my main verb. And after this, I have placed my adverb. That is the first one which we are talking about, after the verb. So after my verb, I have placed this adverb now. Okay? Then you see the next sentence. The tiger attacked us ferociously. So here, the tiger is your subject, right? The tiger, here you was your subject. Okay? So now in this sentence, the tiger is the subject. Attack is your verb. Right? That is your main verb. Okay? Then us is your object. And then they have told after the object. So here ferociously is my adverb. Right? So in this sentence, I am having an object. That is us. Okay? So now ferociously, that is the adverb, is placed after the object. Right, children? Understood? The first one, the first sentence, you can go now. They had told us to place after the verb when there is no object. Okay? Now, in this sentence, you is the subject. Can is your modal. If you remember, we have done modals. Then go is your main verb. And then I have placed the adverb now. Right? In my second sentence, the tiger, which is your subject, okay, attacked is my main verb, us is the object, and after that I have placed the adverb ferociously, right? So they had told in the second point that after the object. So I hope that this is clear. Then come to the next point, okay? Now when I am having adverb of frequency, so that time where do I place it? I will place between the subject and the verb, or between the auxiliary verb and the main verb. Okay? So that means two options I am getting. Either I place it between the subject and the verb, or between the auxiliary verb and the main verb. Auxiliary verb means either my helping verb, either my modal. So between that and the main verb. Right? Now you see in this sentence, she never reaches school on time. So now here, first one they told between the subject and the verb. Now she is my subject here. Okay? Reaches is the main verb over here. Then school is your object. Okay? So now here I have used never between my subject and my verb, right? Then the next one they had told that between the auxiliary verb and the main verb. So now here you see I often sleep off in the classroom. So now here I have not used any auxiliary verb. So in this, now you see in the adverb of frequency, where are we supposed to place them, right? Between the subject and the verb that is done. Now here, between the auxiliary verb and the main verb, right? Now here, and between the auxiliary verb and the main verb. Now let us see in this sentence, okay? She cannot always go for her music class, right? Now in this, the auxiliary verb is can, right? This is my auxiliary verb. Then the main verb. Now where is my main verb? Go is my main verb, right? And in between these two, I have placed my adverb of frequency. This is my adverb of frequency, right? So children, here the adverb of frequency can be placed between the auxiliary verb and the main verb, right? Now in this we see the be forms of the verb when we are using. Now remember the be forms of the verb. I hope that you remember. Those are is, am, are, was, were. Okay, these are the be forms of the verb. Okay, now here when we are using the be forms of the verb, the adverb is placed after the verb. Okay, so that means here she is rarely late to school. Now here this is the be form of the verb. Remember, okay, don't forget, this is the be form of the verb. Under the be form of the verb, we have the words is, am, are, was, were. Okay, now under this be form of this verb, we are, after this we are using the adverb. Okay, this is the point which has been explained over here. Rarely is used after is. That is the be form of the verb. Okay, then I am usually prompt for answering. So now again you see am is coming under the be form of the verb. So here I am usually. This is your adverb. Understood, children? Then the next point. So when we are having the auxiliary verbs have to and used to, we will be placing the adverb before this auxiliary verb have to or used to, right? So now here, like, I often have to accompany my parents. I often, this is your adverb. Have to, this is your the verb which you are using. Okay, I often have to accompany my parents. Then she never used to exercise. Okay, so now again here I have used, I have placed the adverb never before my used to. Okay, so when I am having have to and used to phrases, before them I have to place my adverbs, right? Then this is such a cute puppy. Now here you see this is your demonstrative verb. Is your helping verb. Okay, then a is your article, cute is your adjective, and then puppy is your noun. Now where do I place my adverb? My adverb has to be placed before my adjective and an article. So before that I have to place my adverb, right? Then in the other example, these questions are relatively easy. So which is my adjective here? Again I will be placing it before the adjective. Then so here relatively is my adverb and easy is my adjective. So children, I hope that till here you have understood. Okay, enough, the adverb enough is placed after the word it modifies. So this word enough, we will always place the word which it is modifying or it is explaining more about it. Okay, so now you see in this sentences, I have walked long enough. So the word here, walked that is your verb, and here your the adjective that is long, and that is what it is modifying, and then the word, the adverb enough is written. Okay, so that means it is modifying the verb and the adjective, and then we place enough, right? Then the other one, she has been punished enough. So now here you see the word punished, that is your verb, and so that is what it is modifying, and then we place the word enough. So this situation comes only with the word enough, specifically with the word enough. Okay, so now children, I have completed explaining the placement of our adverbs in a sentence. So I hope that you have understood. Please watch it carefully and as well go through your reader the textual part, and the exercises I will be explaining again. Okay, so thank you and have a wonderful day.